Jesus is looking for people who will actually believe his word, believe the Bible, and go to him first for everything. I'm really new. Really new at figuring out who Jesus is. But he's showed me a lot really fast. And he will, if you're really, really wanting to find him. He'll come out of hiding pretty quick. It's not like he just randomly appears in person, like face to face. That's not how he appears. He appears in spirit, and he talks to us in different ways. There's so many worldly people, and people in church are like, oh, well, God's not speaking to you. You're not hearing from God. You're hearing from the enemy. They don't think you hear from God, a lot of them, unless it's like some big, oppressive, like, I'm going to knock you down to your feet and tell you that, you know, they expect some big audible experience, and he's not dominating. I mean, the enemy wants to dominate us. I mean, he has spoken to people, like in the Bible he spoke to people audibly, but it's not very common. But he can do it, but from what I've learned, he talks to you. He'll talk to you through people, or he'll give you thoughts or memories and say, hey, remember this? How did you feel then? What were you feeling then? And then he'll allow you to see why you were feeling that way. Or he could talk to you in dreams. Or he could actually talk to you audibly, but that's not a common thing, because I think that ends up defeating the walk by faith, not by sight. I think it's kind of similar with, you know, walk by hearing the inner voice versus walk by hearing his audible voice all the time. I don't know if you heard that. It sounded like a giant frog or something over there. That was really cool. But I just realized a lot of people in the churches are being fooled. There's a lot of false dreams. False dreams, everybody thinking we're gonna get raptured, we're all gonna disappear before Jesus comes. But we're supposed to be ready always. We could die tomorrow. Rapture is worldly. There's a lot of false rapture dreams everywhere. Everybody thinks the rapture's happening. This is exactly what the devil wants people to think. He wants us to think we're all gonna disappear. Oh my gosh! That is so awesome! There is a giant fish literally leaping out of the air. Oh my gosh. It was so cute. I'm gonna move over here and see if we can capture it. But there's all these people thinking we're just gonna magically disappear, and that's why there are people who are asleep. So many people are asleep, people who are in the church system, people who aren't even going to church but are still claiming Jesus. Everybody's thinking that we're going to magically disappear, and that's why they're asleep. They're not living for Jesus now. they're not going through their own trials and tribulations. They're all thinking, oh, I had a hard day at work. I didn't make my boss happy enough. And he treated me like crap because I couldn't make him happy. Blah, blah, blah. That's not trial and tribulation. It's not. But the thing is, his voice is not, it's getting muddled up. It's getting so confused. People are not hearing it because they're filling their time with video games or TV worldly things or worldly music. All these things that don't speak about Jesus, they're putting their time in it. Anything and everything that isn't to do with Jesus. And they're asleep. They're not listening for him. They're thinking that the people who are actually following him, who are actually speaking any truth, that they're the ones hearing from the devil. And the reason being is because they're going against the ocean of deception, the ocean of people who are just doing the same thing, the same things. No one wants to believe that the division in the churches is because they don't have the Holy Spirit. People want to be able to go to church and fellowship with people even though they still want to do all these things and watch all these things that God hates. Nobody wants to accept that it's that hard, it's that narrow, that they will literally have to be that separate. Following Jesus is separation from those who will separate you from him. It's not just sit here and tell everybody, oh, you're a good person. You're a good person, so we're all okay. We can't stop. Well, that kind of thinking is the devil. It's not Jesus. Jesus is the one telling you to strive to overcome and that he will help us overcome, but we have to be crying out to him to give us strength to overcome. If we're not even asking for strength to overcome, we're already failing. But that fish isn't over here anymore. Oh, wait, I just saw it. Oh, did you see it? I didn't quite see it, but it's there. Oh, hello, bee. I just had a bee fly by my face and stop. I don't know where this fish is. I want it to pop up.